stars. Some come from farmers, come from bars. Stars, we all got stars. You can try and hide them, and there they are. Yeah, we all got stars. Make you who you are. Show me your stars. In the thing called life, we've all felt too much pain. Scars make us different, and yet they make us all the same. Maybe someone hurt you badly, or you just did something dumb. Those scars are medals and show what you have overcome. Scars, we all got scars. Some come from love, others come from bars. Stars, we all got stars. You can try and hide them, but there they are. Yeah, we all got stars. Make who you are. Show me your stars. That what does not kill us makes us strong, so they say. So all that we can do is get stronger every day. If you're bruised and bleeding and you feel like giving up, get back on your feet again. No scars and did you love. That's a battle daily, and you know that it ain't fair. But your scars are armor, protects if you can't wear. Stars, we all got stars. Some come from far, others come from bars. Stars, we all got stars. You can try and hide them, but there they are. Yeah, we all got stars. Everywhere you go, all got scars. Everyone you know, we all got scars. Some shoot and blow, we all got scars. Made it so, we all got scars. Who's the guy? I got scars. I'm trying to hide. I got scars.
What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Where It Begins with Chris Lane Sr.
Aloha, Steve. How are you?
Good. How are you? Aloha, brother.
I am great, man. If you look down my title, I'm here to play music and drink whiskey. And so cheers to everyone in the chat. Hey,
cheers. Cheers to that. I don't know what my green screen, if you could see mine, but
it's a bottle shape. It's a see-through bottle.
It's a green bottle. Green bottle. It goes with green screen. Perfect.
Yeah. Well, very good. How are you doing over there in Hawaii? How is the weather at the moment?
Good. Actually, in like the past last two, where it begins, I did it, rained. It was pouring rain both times, and it's not raining right now. So that's a good thing.
Not at the moment here, which is delightful for Denver is high desert. People don't know that because they see the mountains and all the snow. But we have had the rainiest June on record. I was born and raised here, and I've lived here again since 76, and it's never rained like that. Today we had hail, a tornado 5 miles south of me, torrential rain, and, you know, later there'll be flooding and grasshopper pestilence probably. We get it all.
That's what I don't miss about Michigan.
Yeah.
For sure. But so for anyone that's in chat that may not know who you are or know about you, you want to say a little something about yourself or your YouTube channel or any other social media site you might have?
Well, allow me to introduce myself. I am a man of wealth and taste. No, that was somebody else. My name is Chris Lane Sr., and I am a serious guy and a serious goofball all at the same time. Been playing music since I was a young person, and like a lot of us, got out of it to a certain extent. I always kind of played just for my own amusement, but I quit being a professional musician in my early to mid-20s. Not that my professional career was that spectacular. Wanted to be the next Van Halen, not so much. That didn't happen. So, you know, got married, had kids, you know, had a life and everything. And like many of you, when COVID came around, I was stuck at home and I needed something to do. And in the interim, when I wasn't playing, now many years ago, I had joined a church and the pastor came to me and said, just out of the blue, I've been praying for a bass player. I thought, how odd, because that's what I played. I'm primarily a bass player, singer. And so I thought, how in the world am I an answer to some pastor's prayer? But I signed up, and I played bass and sometimes guitar in church for a long time. And then when the pandemic came along and we got shut out of everything, I couldn't see my friends and I couldn't play music and I didn't know what the heck to do with myself. So I stood in line with a mask on like a moron at an electronics store and bought an input-output device for my computer and fired up GarageBand as my DAW and started recording, and the rest, they say, is history.
Nice. Yeah, so as horrible as that whole COVID thing was, in the long run, it kind of helped a lot of people out, right?
Well, like everything in life, you know, there's two sides of the same coin. Obviously, it was terrible. People got sick. Some people died. And certainly the lockdowns and the kids not being able to go to school and people losing their jobs, on and on and on. There was so much negative associated with it. But on the positive side, on the other side of the coin, you built different relationships, you changed up your routine and everything, and I've literally made friends of musicians all over the world, which I never would have had the opportunity to do. And I count that as a tremendous blessing.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Hey, Ironton Auditor, Conspiracy Music, Lady Campion, Daniel, Pookie, Ed, everybody, wow. What's up?
Yeah, we got a good crew. Hi to all of the, I know all of you people, and thank you for coming. It's really cool to see y'all.
Blue Unicorn, yeah, nice.
Oh, Blue, a fellow Coloradan up the highway north.
Well, if anyone here doesn't know who Chris Lane is, we need to get him at least 21 more subscribers by the end of the show. So share this out. And let's get him some more subscribers, because that is the whole point, is to get awesome music for more ears to hear.
Yeah, and I mean, that's, for me, that's never been a huge goal, obviously. Every single sub I get is gratifying in that means somebody listened to some of my music and enjoyed it enough to to see what else I was doing. So for each and every one of you who is sub currently, I thank you very much. That's very cool. And, you know, if you haven't subbed me, give me a try. And you might say, no, he's an idiot, and unsub me, and that's okay. But you might find something you like, too.
I'm pretty sure you'll find something you like. I'll vouch for it.
That's been fun. Hey, there's my buddy Hugh Caldwell.
Hugh Caldwell. Here,
now, you're ready for the code word? Mozzarella. And Hugh knows what that means. Again, it's fun to have friends all over the world, and, you know, and who doesn't need some Scotsmen as friends? And if we play one of those videos later on, you'll see my good friend Hugh Caldwell ripping up the guitar.
Oh, nice.
And there's my other buddy, Dom Torregrossa. And that's how you pronounce it, Dominator. Folks, in case you're confused. The Dominator. He's a great guy. And again, who has become literally one of my best friends in the world, even though we've only known each other for about 2 years. But we have shared through our music and in our relationship a whole lot of life. And that's a very cool thing.
He's a great guy. I have a lot of respect for him, man. He was on this show, and it was a great show. And then we talked a few times since then, and he's such a great, great guy, man.
Yeah,
we need more Doms in the
even
world.
Even for a New Yorker, he's a pretty good guy.
Yeah, you gotta give him the benefit of the doubt, you know. New York.
Yeah. Well, you know, they interact with the world the way New Yorkers interact with the world, which is very different from the way Westerners react to the world, and which is probably different than Hawaii. And, you know, you are where you live. Well,
I'm from Detroit, so yeah, it took me a couple of years to get used to the difference out here. Big difference.
Very different vibe than Detroit. Yeah, I was. I was in Detroit for a month, a couple days. Yeah, that is
great.
And this was back in the battle. It was rugged. This was 2000, and I want to say it was 2008. So, you know, downtown Detroit was either boarded up buildings or a war zone. It was brutal. It's doing better now, which is good.
2008. That was like right around the same time I moved here.
Yeah. Yeah, I can see why you would leave Michigan in that time frame. It was not doing well in Detroit.
Rock City. Detroit Rock City. Yep.
All right. Eating steak and potatoes. Good call. If you're eating tofu out there, that's your choice, I guess, but I wouldn't. This doesn't seem to be a tofu eating kind of show. I could be wrong. I don't judge. Eat what makes you happy. Drink what makes you happy. Smoke what makes you happy. Just don't do too much of any of those things, and you're good.
So you're saying that when you're a bass player, so bass is your like primary.
Yeah, bass has always been my primary instrument, but I taught myself to play guitar early on because, let's face it, you know, unless you got a drummer and a couple other guys, playing bass by yourself ain't that fun. So I've always played guitar. I consider myself a decent guitar player, not a whole lot more. Although, of course, you know, I play leads on my videos for certain songs and everything, or, you know, if I can't convince one of my friends to do it. I just do it. But yeah, I do consider myself, even after all this time, to be primarily a bass player. That's the instrument I love. That's what got me into music. When I was about 17, and a buddy of mine from high school had a bass. It was a cheap bass, you know, a Fender Precision knockoff, and like a Univox amp with a single 15 in it. And he sold me the whole rig for $75. Because I just loved the sound of bass. I thought that was the coolest part. In my car stereo, I had a 5-band equalizer, you know, in 1977. And, you know, I had the bass jacked up because that's what I wanted to hear. And so that was the instrument that turned me on.
That's what I still have in my work van now. I got at the bass. So I'm the same way. I love the bass. So
yeah. Apparently, it's all about the bass. I heard that someplace.
That's funny, because yeah, I'm 47 years old, yeah, and I drive around like I'm 19. I got my, it's actually a funny story, but it isn't about me, but real quick, I got to tell it because it's funny. I ran into a guy that owns an audio store, and he needed plumbing work done, so we kind of bartered, I guess, you know. He's like, well, I need three toilets installed in my house, and da-da-da, and I'm like, well, half the day I'm driving in my work van, so I want good music, you know, good sounds. So I got like a $2,500 stereo system for like $350 or $400. And then I was supposed to install the toilets and do some plumbing work for him. Thing is, he never called me back for the plumbing till this day. So I got a very expensive audio stereo system for very cheap.
Maybe. Or you might get a call at midnight sometime with your buddy, and he goes, you know, I really need those toilets right now.
Right.
And then you'll have to make an emergency call. That could happen. That's the thing about being a plumber. All right. So what do we want to do on this thing? You have some questions for me, or do we want to talk to the chat? Do we want to play some music? I am your guest. You tell me how you want it.
We want to start out with some live.
Sure.
Get everybody in the mood with some live music.
Absolutely. I have my trusty guitar, which I tuned earlier today. I hope it's still in tune. Sounds like it is. Well, you can kind of see from my moniker, people probably know me a little bit from two songs. We started with Scars, and then this song is another song that, this is my less serious side. And this is a song called I Drink Whiskey. I drink whiskey, you tell lies, you cheat on me. Ain't no surprise. Don't shut your mouth. Don't shut your thighs. So I drink whiskey. Well, you tell lies. Well, I started on the day we said I do. And you swore that your love was true. Till you had the judge of my best man too. And then you slept with all the cleaning crew. Yeah, from that day it went from bad to worse. A cheating woman's nothing but a curse. Do I become a man that I abhor? Just a lonely drunk who's married to a whore. I drink whiskey. You tell lies, you cheat on me, ain't no surprise. Don't shut your mouth, don't shut your thighs. So I drink a whiskey, you tell lies, well no more lies. Working in your daddy's company, I bust my hump while he lies and cheats and steals. Well, he made me partner, and that's all right with me. I have sold the company's stocks to the Chinese. With that pile of cash, I think I'll go. Gonna make my way on down to Mexico. I'll take it easy, and I'll take it slow. With a lovely senorita who's not a hoe. And I'll drink a whiskey, and on the beach I'll lie. And I'll watch this beautiful sunrise. I left your ass.
us with no goodbyes. And I drink whiskey, and you can lie. I drink a whiskey, maybe a little tequila. But I won't miss you. Hey, bartender, trace whiskeys, por favor. Mucho gracias, hombre. Keep the change, amigo.
I drink whiskey. Awesome. And it's important to point out, because that song, when Jade Starr interviewed me, she said, there sounds like there's a story behind that. And there is. The story is, I have a really good imagination. I have been happily married for 34 years. I've never encountered that. That is not my reality. But it's fun to think about alternate realities, and that's where that song came from. Kind of a send-up of some of the old country western kind of tripes that you hear. So
that's cool, and it's upbeat too. I mean, it got me going.
It's happy and upbeat while being really dark. Right. So I like that contrast. That was fun for me.
That's awesome. Yeah, good imagination can go a long way.
Yeah. And this is something that we kick around in Songwriters Anonymous, and I'll talk a little bit about the group in a minute. But we always have this debate, you know, do I write about my life experience, or do I write about made-up events, or some combination? And everybody's different in that respect. Dom, until recently, tended to write about things he'd experienced or really could put himself in that situation, whereas I'm kind of the opposite. And I write one of two ways. It's, I've got a message to send, but I don't want it to be an obvious message, so I'll bury it a little bit. Or I'm just screwing around and I'm having fun. And you'll get that little bit of my sense of humor, like on a song like that. Kind of a take a situation and make it just beyond ridiculous.
Right. That's cool, though, man. I love that. Because I write lyrics, but everything I write, it's always something I've been through or something personal. But I like that. I should start using my imagination and using it for lyrics rather than just only being able to write about something I've been through. Because, I mean, that's how they write movies, right? They just make shit up in their head.
A lot of the... And, you know, if you have some empathy, and I'm wearing my lupus shirt, which is, the yellow is fading out, but my wife is a longtime lupus sufferer, and so it was God's little joke. Here's a big, you know, football guy, and my attitude was, you know, if you're hurt and rub dirt on it, you know, get over yourself. Well, lupus is an incurable chronic disease that attacks your immune system. So, you know, like I said, we've been happily married for 34 years, and she continues to work and everything, God willing, because she's on good medication. But when she was first diagnosed almost 30 years ago, they gave her, lupus was tended to be a death sentence for people, and because your kidneys will fail, you know, and on her initial diagnosis, she should have been dead 5 years ago. Well, because of HCQ and other protocols that they treat lupus patients with, she's, you know, had a productive life. Her kidneys are stable. She does have kidney disease, as all lupus patients eventually develop, but they're stable. And where I'm going with all that is it took a, you know, an old jock and made me quickly develop empathy for other people, especially medical things. And so it allows me to put myself in other people's positions because I've developed that bit of empathy. This is a big reason why Dom Torregrossa and I are good buddies. He's a cancer survivor. I'm a cancer survivor. And so we have that cancer club fraternity between us, and we understand things that if you haven't had cancer or hadn't had a close family member go through it, you might not be able to understand. And so that's where, you know, you kind of get this thing where you can project into other people's situations a little bit better and say, okay, if I was in that situation, how would I feel? How would I react? If I was going to write a song about it, how would I approach it? And that is what Songwriters Anonymous is all about. It's a group that was started by Dom, and he invited me along, not because I was a songwriter, honestly, at all. I was a bass player, and I played on a couple of his tracks, and I thought this would be a fun way for me to play bass for people and just kind of hang out and give suggestions on lyrics or whatever. And before you knew it, I started writing songs, and you know, I've developed a decent catalog in the last couple of years just because of being in this group with like-minded people that we bounce ideas off one another and have the freedom to say, I think you're a terrific songwriter and I think this is a terrific song, but this verse sucks and here's why this verse sucks and you need to change the lyrics here. Or I never say that. I don't feel comfortable doing that, but I will. My code word is, may I suggest?
You say it in a polite way.
Yeah, when I say may I suggest, that's my code for I don't think that part's working and maybe you should think about doing it a different way. And
it's good that, but it could be better.
And that's what it's all about. Yeah, get better. You know, I've gotten better because of my association with these people, and they're not shy about pointing out if something of mine is a little weak. It's been a couple of times where they said, this song is amazing, but I got, you know, we're 8 minutes in. Maybe you should think about cutting down the lyrics a little bit. You're trying to tell, say too much. Maybe edit yourself, which is laughable because that's what I do for a living. I'm an editor of books and magazines, but, you know, physician, heal thyself, right? Editor, edit yourself and cut down the song a little bit.
That's funny. 8 minutes in. Maybe we should.
Yeah, maybe, I mean, this was a very compelling song 3 minutes ago. You know, now. Anyway, and I apologize. If you see any questions or anything in the chat, you know, go ahead and read them to me. I'm far enough back from my computer that I'm really, I've got 20/20 vision still. Except for close-up, which is why I wear these, and they're just—I'm just back enough that I can't really read the chat very well. I can see people's names and I can see their picture, but I can't really.
Right. Yeah, I was actually just going to ask if anyone in chat has questions, but I haven't seen any. Except Ray Pierce said not asking you to play it on stream tonight, Chris, but would like to post a link to my new song, and then he posted the link. But
oh, cool. Well, very good, Ray. Yeah, Ray's been hanging out on the streams. He's just seems like he's a super good guy. So thanks for being here.
Yeah, Ray, if you do get a hold of me, I if you're a musician, man, I'd love to have you on.
Yeah. Yeah, talk to Steve. Talk to Chris is a poopy head. Well, yeah, you know me, Chad. So yeah. And?
Chad.
What's your point?
That's what
sticks and stones, brother. I'm not offended by your words. Be offended if you had a party and you didn't call me. That would offend me.
Daniel says, Chris,
thank you.
You rock. Can you read this now?
Yeah, he did it in all caps. That I could read. But don't do it all in caps. You don't have to shout at me.
And Blue Unicorn says, I have a question. How?
You know, the more important Easily. Question, Blue, is why? Think about that, buddy.
I just want to know when. I just want to know when.
Sooner than you think. All right.
Mr. Smith, is your stylist expensive?
My stylist is, and I... You know, we might as well address the elephant in the room. I've got pretty awesome hair, but I get that from my mother. I'm very fortunate. I have good genetics. I am, Chris says, may I suggest, quite frequently. Yeah. Well, Dom knows me, and he knows my methodology. But it's just good genetics. My mother is 84 years old, still drives around, still has a glorious head of thick blonde hair, and that's where it comes from. So I take a shower every day and I wash it with whatever cheap shampoo was on sale at Walmart. And then I let it dry. And that is the extent of my style. I do comb it occasionally. And I tried to before the show, but the humidity here is so brutal. Yeah, the humidity is brutal, which is kind of wavy here. It just I couldn't even comb it out because it is what it is. So there you go.
And see, if I didn't put anything in my hair, I'd have the white man's fro, because it's just
yeah.
But it's not curly or anything. It's just straight hair. But it just is.
Yeah. Indeed. May I suggest would be a very cool. Well, maybe that's Maybe that's a segment we need to do on our show, Dom. May I suggest? You know that.
Yeah,
stop
there you
sucking.
Go.
May I suggest you stop doing
name
that?
It. You can title it. May I suggest?
Yeah, you never know. All right. What else do we want to do? Want to play another song?
I'm not going to stop you.
All right, well. I'll play this one. This is one that I kind of wrote specifically for my wife, and it's something called Let's Fly. In your tears, a prisoner of all your fears. Don't cry, baby, don't cry. I bind you up and make you whole. I do my best to heal your soul. I'll try, baby, I'll try. Things you've seen, done the things you did to just go on. I know living life has left you weak, but I can look inside and know you're strong. It holds you hostage in your tears. A prisoner of all your fears. Don't cry, baby, don't cry. I bind you up and make you whole. I do my best to heal your soul. I'll try, whoops, oh, baby, I'll try. Forgive yourself. Just to live and find another day. They say it's darkness before the dawn, but I promise it won't always be this way. Yeah, yeah. The time has come for us to grow and leave behind those things we know. Let's try. Don't fear the things we think we lack. Let's fly, oh, baby, let's fly. Let's fly. Let's fly.
Right on.
Does Chris Lane swerve or keep the car straight in the lane? It depends. We do have an expression in my family, and it's called stay in your lane, which means we all have areas of expertise and we all have things that we have no flipping idea what we're talking about. And if you're in one of those areas, don't go to that area. Stay in your lane. Stick to things you know.
Yep. Yeah, I like that. So, that's, you know what, Chris, I think we were talking about earlier, if it starts to do that, to let you know, I think it's starting to like get a little choppy with your connection.
All right. Well, that may be whether I did the pre switch up to go the more stable connection. So I don't know. We could go back to the other one and see if it works, because that could happen. I don't know. Maybe we'll see. How choppy was it? If the video's choppy, I don't care. Was the music cutting out a little bit or crackly?
The music a little bit, and then like just 10 seconds ago, it was real, sounded like a robot. But now it just got better, so.
Yeah, it may, again, because the weather here is so dicey, we may have some issues with that off and on, and we'll persevere. If it really stinks, you can wave at me and I'll knock it off and we can talk for a minute and then we can try again if we have to, but.
Right, well, yeah, because it's better now. Better now.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, well, I'm not sending as much signal. All right. Well, what else would you like to know that you think your audience would be interested in?
Well, I've listened to all your music until an hour ago, and I watched one of your videos. I'm like, I can't believe I've never seen this one or heard it yet. But from your music, I'm guessing rock and roll, a little bit of country, maybe some blues mixed in there. But what was your most genre that really got you into it?
I'm a rock guy first and foremost. But I learned to play along with ZZ Top records. So I'm very strong blues influence, and I love the blues. And of course, I went back as I learned more and went to the old blues masters, back to Robert Johnson even. And so that, I think if you're going to play rock music, you really need to have a strong understanding of the blues and the roots of that sort of music. Because a lot of the things that we do is based on that. Certainly country is. Now, there is a strong country influence in me, not because I'm a huge country music fan, because I'm really not. But I went to college in a small town in southwest Colorado called Durango. And people might know that because it has a steam-powered railroad that's been there since 1881. And that was one of the reasons I went there. But it had a great business school, and I got my business degree down there. And I was like the only bass player for like 100-mile square radius for a couple of years. So anybody who needed a bass player, I got the gig. And so I played a lot of country and Western and that stuff. And again, not because I particularly loved it, but you know, I like getting paid same as anybody else. So, and you know, you play enough of that stuff and it creeps into you a little bit. And of course, later I developed such a huge appreciation for Americana, bluegrass, Celtic music, the music of my ancestors from both Ireland and, you know, back when they came across and probably lived in Appalachia and that kind of stuff. So I listen to that frequently. And so that is a little bit of an influence. But I love rock and really, you know, 70s hard rock, early 80s. I, of course, played in hair metal bands because... and I like that kind of stuff. What I liked about it is I love the screaming guitars and the thumpy bass, but I like the vocals a lot of that era of music. I mean, a lot of those guys are 3-4 part harmonies, and it turns out a lot of them were building it in the studio and everything, and they couldn't actually always deliver live. Although, I mean, some of them could. Don Dawkins, great singer. Jeff Tate of Queensryche, great singer.
Oh yeah,
Lance Staley, great singer. So, yeah, a lot of those guys really could deliver the goods. But and so that's why I like that stuff too. So kind of one of my heroes, Michael Anthony. I mean, here's a burly guy, and you know, playing bass and singing way up high. And you know, in college, my first band, I didn't really start singing right away. We had a lead singer, but the dude was like a low baritone. And so he's, you know, rah, 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 like this, and like, this ain't working in rock and roll. And so I started singing a little bit, and we quickly discovered that my voice, I could sing much higher than, you know, anybody else in the band. And so just started working on that and developing it. And, you know, I'm pretty fortunate that, you know, I'm 61 years old and I can still sing as high as I can sing. You know, allegedly you lose, you know, notes as you get older. But that's not been my experience so far. In fact, I can actually sing two notes higher than I could when I was in my 20s.
So, yeah, it gets better with age,
I guess. Let's hope that continues. You know, very few other things get better with age. You know, wine, whiskey, but for the rest, not so much. Anyway.
Yeah, my 80s rock and metal hair band, man, that brings back so many good memories.
Yeah, and a lot of those bands were, you know, one-hit wonders. They weren't that great, but some of them were probably, if you look at them objectively as the time has passed, they're maybe better than we gave them credit for in some aspects. I'm blanking the name of the band, but Jerry Lane was their singer and primary songwriter. And, you know, they had Cherry Pie was their big hit. And of course, he loathed that song. Didn't even want to put it on the record. Poison, thank you. Well, is that right? Poison?
I'm not Cherry sure. Cherry Pie, right. I think Poison sang Cherry Pie.
No, that doesn't sound
Warren.
Right.
Warren.
That's who it is, Warren. Warren. Okay. Their album, Uncle Tom's Cabin, is brilliant. And I mean, great stuff. But, of course, that isn't what got played, per se. And, you know, it was sad because the guy was so tore up by, you know, his personal demons and things that, you know, he ended up not living as long as he should have. But, yeah, some of those guys were pretty talented. And then some of them were, you know, quite right. It was some of the individual players. Rudy Starr, a great bass player, you know, but the band itself. Yeah, so what? They weren't that great. Anywho. But I was fortunate to see a lot of those guys, you know, live as they came through. And I've been fortunate. I've seen a lot of cool bands. I saw Queen when they were touring Day at the Races. And man, that Brian May and Freddie Mercury and, of course, John Deacon, great bass player. And Roger Taylor, great singer, great drummer. What a band. So, the first concert I ever went to was Cheap Trick opening for Kansas. And like, okay, this is good stuff. And, you know, went from there. My second concert was Queen and Billy Squire opened for him. And that was right before his album came out. So nobody had ever heard of the guy.
Those are the best, though. You get to hear a band before nobody. Because I've seen a few bands that, like, Three Doors Down, I seen them when nobody knew who they were.
Yeah.
I didn't even know who they were. But I was like, wow, this band, good, dude. And then I seen Nickelback before anyone knew who they were. And I know a lot of people hate on Nickelback, but I still think they're a good band.
They're a good band.
I don't know why everyone hates on them. But.
Well, it's just because, again, people follow trends, I guess.
Yeah, that's true. But what was your most memorable? Like, what? You're not memorable. You're, well, yeah, memorable, but your best memory of concert that if you could go back and do it again, you'd be like, oh, I'd be there right away.
Well, obviously with you know, Mercury's passing and everything, I'd go back to that Queen concert in a heartbeat. I mean, it was a killer good show, just top notch in every respect. Kansas had just released Left Overture, so that was a great concert. And you know, I've seen the Police twice. I saw the Police, honestly, at a little place called the Rainbow Music Hall here in Denver. And you'd get a lot of smaller acts in there. It was a great music hall. And the Police were touring their second album, so nobody knew who these dudes were. But we were just frequent flyers there. I would work night shift with a buddy of mine, and we'd just get off work, buy a case of beer, go sit in the parking lot and drink beer, and then they'd open the doors, and we'd see who was ever playing that weekend. And one of those times it was the Police before anybody had ever heard of them. I had actually heard of them because I'd found their record, their first record, and I'm like, I like these guys. Show was great, and then of course, then they released their third album, and then everybody knew who the Police were, and so that was very cool to see them when they were young. And I saw the Divinyls there, you know, again when nobody knew who they were, and Marshall Tucker and
Marshall Pure Tucker, Prairie yeah. Lincoln.
Yeah, I've seen. I was been very fortunate. I can probably say that just the handful of concerts that I didn't really enjoy. Edgar Winter was a snore. It just wasn't great. He's a great guitar player, but it's not a great show. And George Thorogood, honestly, was just, you know, it just wasn't a great show.
I wouldn't have expected that. Wow.
Yeah. It was at Red Rocks too, and it just could have been a bad night, but you know, they didn't have it that night. They weren't great, and you know, my kids were very much into the power punk rock scene, so I took them to see Blink 182 and you know, Newfound Glory and Fall Out Boy and all those kinds of bands, Green Day, and
that was like our 80s, but the younger generation, 90s.
Yeah, exactly. So, you know, the old man took him to the shows and, you know, said, hey, have fun, boys, you know, and those were some good concerts. Now, it was interesting that I saw Blink and they were amazing, and then they came back a year later with Green Day, and Blink was the headlining act. Green Day blew them off the stage. They were way better than Blink. It was surprising. Honestly, but you never do know. You catch people good nights and bad nights.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. Well, shoot. I got another video. We've been going about 45 minutes. I don't know if you want to get a refill on your whiskey or whatever. But
I'm doing okay on the whiskey so far. But yeah, if we want to play a video, and that's fine. And we can. Which video are you thinking about playing?
Please read the letter.
Okay, yeah, we can play this video. This is a cool video. This is my good friend Lady Rodeline Strait from the UK, and then I can tell people a little bit the genesis of this and, you know, how I kind of started collaborating with some other people in the community. So, yeah, why don't we fire that up?
Nice. Cool. All right, here we go.
Caught up running with a little too much to hide. Maybe, baby, everything's gonna turn out fine.
Please read the letter. I mailed it to your door. It's crazy how it all turned out. We needed so much more. Too late, a fool could read the signs. Maybe, baby, you better check between the lines. Please read the letter, I wrote it in my sleep. With help and consultation from the angels of the deep. Oh,
once I stood besides a well of many words. My house was full of rings and charms and pretty birds.
Please understand me,
my walls came falling down. There's nothing here that's left for you but check with lost and found. Oh, please read the letter that I wrote. One more song just before we go. Remember, baby, you gotta reap just what you sow. Please read my letter and promise me you'll keep the secrets and the memories we cherish in the deep. Please read the letter, I nailed it to your door. It's crazy how it all turned out, we needed so much more. Please read the letter that I wrote. Please read the letter that I wrote. Please read the letter.
That's a great song. Great song.
Yeah, that's my good friend, Lady Rhoda Line Straight. And she's become a good friend. Obviously, she's a great vocalist. And I'd seen her in the community doing various things. And out of the blue, she emailed me one time and said, hey, I'd like to work with you. And I looked around and said, who, me? Because I'm nobody. But she emailed me and said, look, I know this song between Alison Krauss and Robert Plant, and I think you'd sound great on it. And I thought, are you kidding me? Doing Robert Plant takes a pair. But I said, I'll try, and did it, and it turned out pretty good. And our voices match very well together, and we've done some other things together based on that. But it was a great experience to just get out of your comfort zone. I mean, I never would have approached her and said, hey, by the way, we should do this thing together. But she reached out and approached me, and I'm so glad she did. And that has led to me collaborating with a number of people And if you go to my channel, you'll see that I've worked with Dom Torregrossa, and I've worked with Hugh Caldwell, and I've worked with, I'm just blanking the name, geez, Moot Tunes. Moot is a fellow Eastern guy, and he's a great guitar player, writes songs, and again, he's a very good vocalist, but he was another guy that reached out to me and said, I want to work with you. I'd love you to sing some of my stuff because I think you got the right voice for it. And we've done several things together, and it's just, it's been fun. This is a long-winded way of saying you can make friends in the community and have a good time. And that's what I'm having the time of my life. I really am. You know, I toured back in the day. Yes. I wouldn't trade that. I wouldn't like to do that for anything now. I love the ability to just, you know, via the internet, reach out to my friends together and do music. It's fantastic. Hey, there's Burns.
That's what
hey,
it's
Burns.
All about. How are you? What's up? Yeah, I was going to say, I seen everybody come in. Aloha. Independent Men United, Lord Spike Protein, Burns. Who else? Steven Sheets. Who else just came in?
Ed has been here for actually a while.
Steve,
oh, my
Cutler
buddy
Coldacre, what's up?
From Down Under. I've worked with my friend Coldacre. Lori's Mishmash, he and I did an Aussie song together, and Coldacre nailed the solo. It was perfect. So, good stuff.
So yeah, at the end of that, a cold wind.
Yes, I will go ahead and play that. And let me give you the backstory of that song. I'm not just in Songwriters Anonymous. I'm in a couple other songwriting groups. Although my participation is spotty. Sometimes the things speak to me. A lot of times they don't. I just the vibe in Songwriters Anonymous is very comfortable for me in a lot of ways. But there was another group that I was in, and they said, you've got to do a song, and you can only use one note or one chord. And I said, oh, God, this will be amazing. Not. But I started with A minor, which is one of my favorites. And I'm just saying, okay, well, because I don't play by the rules, and I never did, what if I do little variations of A minor? If I do some hammer-ons and pull-offs? And I'm playing around with it, and all of a sudden, something hit me from back in college that I'd written. Never did anything with it. And I kind of remembered, and I'm playing along and went, oh, yeah, I kind of remember this song. And it was, and I had one line, a cold wind blows through my door. And my wife and I are huge history buffs. And, you know, she's read all the Little House on the Prairies. And when the pioneers came out and homesteaded, a lot of them, both men and women, but especially the women, could only hack it for a season or two because the isolation was so, and the constant howling of the wind out on the prairie, it literally drove some people crazy. The term crazy train did not come from Ozzy. It was actually a term that the railroaders used in the 1870s, 80s to describe people had lost it out there and they were going back to wherever they came from. And so a cold wind is my imagination of how it might have been out on the prairie trying to homestead back in the, you know, 1870s, 1880s. A cold wind blows through my door, reminds me I'm alone. I wonder what this night has in store, wish you were home. I long for the springtime, when I can see you again. Without you, nights last forever. I wish this winter would end, I wish it would end. A I dream of us in our cabin, sheltered and safe from the storm. I see you standing beside me, me holding and keeping you warm. The neighbors said you went crazy. Well, I'm praying that just isn't true. Cause life on this farm ain't worth living if I'm without you. Nights out on the prairie, the times are so hard. Here, warm in our cabin is where you belong.
Music, man.
Well, it's, you know, again, I got to thank my friend Dom Torregrossa for getting me into it, because I never, and it got me into the songwriting thing. I never would have in a million years thought, oh, I'll just grab an acoustic guitar and just play live in front of people. It just never would have entered my brain. But he started doing it, and he looked like he was having fun. And I'm like, okay, I'll try it, and let's see if I can do this. And started doing it, and it is fun. I got to say, it really is, because it strips the songs down to their elements. I've always said, I think a strong song is one that you can play a lot of different ways. That song, if you listen to it on my channel, is got full orchestration. There are strings behind it and keyboards and bass and all of this. It's a full production, but stripped down, I think the song still works. And it's not true of all of my music, but some of the songs translate into the acoustic versions, I think, fairly well. And it's fun to, you know, just think of the two versions in that way.
I pay Chris down. I pay Chris $5 every time he mentions me.
Well, and it's funny. I mean, we tease each other and everything, but there really is a mutual admiration society. I was not able to, I like to help with his live show on Tuesdays and just, you know, keep the chat running, feed him songs and all that kind of stuff. And I had a guest come into town. I really wasn't able to do it this Tuesday. And he knew that. But, you know, he mentioned Chris. This, oh, Chris played this, and he's telling his guest Chris that, and it's just because we just have a lot of respect for one another, and we plow a lot of the same ground, so, you know, nice to have friends, right?
And you guys are going live today, too, right?
Yeah, right? After this show, yeah, we'll have the...
I wanted to make sure to send everyone over there right after here, because I'll be there. I'll be there in the chat.
Some people may be sick of me and not want to come over, and I certainly would understand that. But if you're, you know, if you want to see what after a little bit of whiskey and not playing guitar, and this is Dom and I do not play. This is a show that we talk about current events in the music community. We just, you know, how our week goes, and we just take off on tangents that interest us, and, you know, people will stay for 2.5-3 hours sometimes. So it's a lot of fun. It's just called the happy hour, and that is. We're just a couple guys sitting in a bar shooting the bull, and, you know, our friends are all invited to come and hang out with us and talk with us, and we try and interact with the chat as much as we possibly can, see what's going on in their lives, and chat about that sort of thing.
Right on. And yeah, just in case, I know most people are, but let's see. Chris and Lane is at 332. Started at 329, is at 332, but I still think we can get that to 350 before the end of the show.
Well, anybody who's joined, I thank you very much. And I will mention that the show is on Dom's channel all this month. Will be alternating. So in July, it'll be on my channel, and then August, it'll go back to his channel, and we're kind of bouncing back and forth. We're, you know, it's streamed on both channels, I think. Or, well, no, we haven't done that, actually. But, yeah, but it'll be on Dom's channel tonight. No one else will be my friend. Oh, that's not true. Dom has at least one other friend.
Or if, let me see. Or if one of my mods could grab the link from Dom's channel.
Yeah, that would be super. It should be scheduled. The happy hour. I know the humidity is bad. The condensation on my wigs is crazy. It's important for people to know, because I live here in Denver, I hate two things. I hate humidity and I hate oxygen. I don't like either, and I try and deal with as little of both of those as I possibly can.
Yeah, because you're, wow, yeah. Never thought, because I've been to, well, I drove from Detroit to Grand Junction, Colorado once. It was an awesome road trip. I was by myself. It took me a week because I took my time. I just drove, you know, 5, 6, 7, 8 hours. A day, depending on how I felt, and then I'd stop wherever I was and just get a hotel. And but yeah, big difference when you go from Michigan to the mountains, then to the valley.
Indeed.
And then now I live at sea level. I literally live at sea level. So
I've been to Hawaii once. I was in high school. And we had just finished playing football and everything. This was my senior trip with my family. And so my brother and I just started running along the beach. And, you know, I mean, I'm a big guy. I played offensive line. I'm not a distance runner. And we're running for, you know, mile after mile. It's because there was so much oxygen, we didn't know what to do. Like, this is amazing. You know, just wasn't even breathing hard. And I also noticed that when I went to New Orleans with some family friends a couple of years ago, my wife and I went with people who we've been friends with forever. And we started in a bar, and we're just drinking and having a good time. We hang out. We order food there and everything. And I walked in. I knew I was going to like this bar because they had Angel's Envy. And if you whiskey drinkers out there know what Angel's Envy is, it is one of the finest bourbons around. It's just delightful. So they had a brand new bottle of Angel's Envy. And I said, oh, I like you guys. And I started ordering that. And we ended up being there for hours and hours. And we finally decided we were going to get the hell out of there. So we get a last call. And I said, all right, give me another Angel's Envy. And the barkeeper, waitress, said, well, I can't. You drank it all. I went, get the F out of here. I cannot drink an entire bottle of whiskey by myself, because I was the only guy drinking it. When I, that's not. And she handed me the bottle, and she said, I can assure you, sir, you can. Damn. So I like sea level, although it's expensive. You know,
right.
Mile high, I have good drinks, and I'm good.
Right.
Yeah. So, and if you ever come to Denver, folks, or you fly on an airplane, that's why people get stupid on airplanes, because they have a couple drinks, and that altitude, it hits you hard. So,
yep.
If you come visit me in Denver,
and you're, it doesn't matter if you got a tolerance, nope. Man. You go up there and, yeah, I have 2, maybe 3 beers on a plane, and I'm like,
yeah,
did I just drink a case of beer? What the hell?
Exactly. Can't do it. So if you come visit me in Denver, drink a lot of water because you need it, and you know, watch your intake. And of course, people who do the marijuana trade, tourist stuff, come out here, especially when it was first legalized, like, oh, I'm going to get some gummies and I'm going to eat edibles and everything. And, you know, some people ran into trouble because they partied a little too hard their first day.
You're a little too excited.
Yeah. Yeah, Chrissy Cat, is that a Kentucky bourbon? Yes, it is. The master distiller from, not Maker's Mark. I apologize, I'm blanking it. But he's Noel, what's Lowell's last name? Anyway, master distiller for years and years. This was his own special blend, his select barrels that he thought was the best, and that's where Angel's Envy comes from. So, a little whiskey trivia there. We talk about drinking whiskey occasionally because both Dom and I like a little bit of whiskey.
So, as far as, so you said you, in your early 20s, you kind of stopped playing and then got back into it with COVID. I believe that's what you said, right?
Yeah, exactly. No, I had had a band, toured around the West a little bit. I guess this, I'll back up and kind of close the loop on the story of the circle. Again, I'm a bass player and I sang backing vocals and everything, but we had a lead singer who didn't know how to craft his buzz and was notorious for getting too drunk and he would lose his voice. So we were a three piece. So, you know, you three piece with a lead singer, well, you lose your lead singer and then I would have to slide over and do the lead vocals. And then we didn't have the backing vocals like we liked. And, you know, after a while that became tiresome. And when I guess got into that myself, that was one of the things, is like, I'm never going to rely on a lead singer. I might not have the greatest voice ever, but I know that I know how to take care of my voice. I can sing a lot and not damage it. And, you know, I know what I sound like. So for my stuff, I'm always going to be the singer. And while I've had a great time singing with others, as we saw with, you know, Lady Rhode Island Straight, I just kind of wanted to set my course that way where I had control of that aspect of it. And, you know, after a while, we weren't getting anywhere. We had an agent who booked us on some fairly terrible gigs, and everybody goes through this. I mean, this is paying your dues. This is what you do. But, like, here's a fun story. We were touring Montana, and, of course, everybody's heard of Custer's Last Stand. And we were going through the Crow Indian Reservation there, and one of the cars broke down. So imagine, if you will, a dude who looks like me with this hair, but I didn't have the goatee then. I just had the big mustache. So the tribal police comes up to me, and here is this General Custer-looking mofo on the reservation there. And he said, "You guys need to get the hell out of here." And we got the hell out of there. And fun things like that, and, you know, having guns pulled on you by club owners. It's like, you know, we said when music stops being fun, maybe we're not going to do it anymore. And I looked at my guitarist at the time, Monty Albee, who still lives here in Colorado, and I said, "Bro, I don't know about you. I ain't having fun." He goes, "This is not exactly how we envisioned this, is it?" So we got home and we said, "Yeah, let's regroup. Let's fire Rex, our singer, drunken idiot, and let's rethink this." And we rethought it to the point where, you know what? And he went on and did some other touring later with another band later in life. But he's kind of like me. He's has been happily married for a long time, and he's works for the school district down in Durango, Colorado now. Was in Delta, Colorado for a long time. Anyway, so there's my boring touring story.
Yeah, but throughout that whole time and everything, what would have been your biggest, like biggest performance as far as like crowd or just your best performance? Like, man, that was the best. Like, I'd go back and do that again any day.
We got invited to do some, you know, kind of festival things, and we had played for several thousand people, and I can't tell you how many thousand, but, you know, so we had a little bit of success and a little bit of notoriety. And man, the energy from a crowd that size is amazing. I gotta tell you. It's amazing and it's terrifying at all at the same time. Because you know, again, you're a three-piece band. You know, the guitarist is doing his thing as, and I like that aspect of being the bass player in a three-piece because you had to work. And I'm not, I don't know, a very busy bass player per se. You know, I would do little runs and everything, but you know, my job was to, like my idol, Dusty Hill, lock it down, be solid, and just keep the groove going. And it's fun, but it's terrifying working without a net of a rhythm guitarist or something with that many people as well. Because if something goes wrong, it goes horribly wrong. We were fortunate that when we played those couple big gigs that, you know, we had good performances. We felt like we did well. You know, it was a good response and that was cool. But yeah, it's unbelievably terrifying and so thrilling when you walk off the stage afterwards and go, that was amazing. You know, I mean, you're just high for a while there. It's quite the rush.
What do they call that? Like dopamine or whatever, just that. Like,
oh yeah. Ugh. Yeah. Well, that's it. Energy. That's why people, yeah, you do that thing, you get that kind of rush and you know, that's why it is a little bit fun, you know, playing live on the internet. You still get some feedback from the chat and everything, and you're getting a little bit of that dopamine rush, and that's pretty cool, honestly.
Yeah. And I mean, that's part of why I love doing it too, but the main thing is, just, like you said earlier, just have fun. You meet great people.
Yeah.
Spread positivity. And you get rewarded for it too with a little bit of dopamine, you know?
Yeah, so exactly.
It's a win-win. It's a win-win.
Yeah. I made a joke the other day, but I'm only partially joking because there's a member of our community who always says, peace and love, man. And, you know, I'm all about that. But for me, it's peace and love, and I'm going to do it very aggressively and in your face. I'm going to peace and love the hell out of you, and you're going to like it because that's my personality.
Right. Man, you have, 38 videos.
Yeah.
Oh, and by the way, you're up to 334, by the way.
Well, God bless you people. You are just wonderful. I'm not falsely modest or humble or everything. I like doing what I do and I think I'm decent, but the fact that anybody else thinks that besides my wife, and that's very gratifying that somebody likes what you do. I mean, that's, we all love affirmation, right? And that's what I take that as, just affirmation that somebody likes what I did. And I really appreciate it, folks.
Right on. And I just noticed too that you do have a video, but I don't know. I think I'd rather hear you sing it, but a Ring of Fire, Johnny Cash cover.
Oh man, I haven't done that one in a while.
Oh no, okay. No, I don't want to like force you, but I'm a big Johnny Cash fan.
I am too. How does that go? Let's see. Yeah, you know what? I'm going to take a pass on that. I have not done one in a while. I have done it live before. But man, for whatever reason, that kind of dropped off my rotation. I'm not exactly sure how to play it at the moment, because I know I changed the key of it specifically for the song. Because again, let's review. My voice is higher. I can't sing as low as Johnny Cash, so I changed the key of it.
And then earlier, the email you sent me with those songs. And I did get a picture of the Inside My Head, but mm-hmm. I don't think I got the video, or did I?
It should, if you click on it, should give you the link. Maybe I'll...
Right. No, I have it here, but I wasn't sure if you, when you emailed me, if you were sending the video as well or just the picture, but because I have the picture, but...
Yeah, no,
But is that one that you don't do live?
No, that's one I don't do live. That one, there's, and if you play the video, you'll quickly figure out why I don't do that one live.
Cool. Well, shoot, you might check this one out real quick. I mean, you've seen it before, but
I'll go ahead and set up the song just a little bit. This is really me. I'm a positive guy, and I view things positively. But let's not kid ourselves. No matter how positive you are, in your mind is always swirling lots of negative thoughts and people telling you you can't do things or self-doubt. And this song explores the voices that we all have in our head and just, you know, kind of processing that. And that's why Inside My Head.
Right on. That's so, yeah, everything you just said is so true. Wow. All right, here we go.
Let me find out. Nobody cares. Might as well just give up. It's never going to work. I can't believe you did that.
I've been fighting so long. I'm tired. What's it like to be loved?
Wow, dude, I have to admit it, that's another song that I have not listened to yet that I thought I've heard all your songs, but
well, how fun is this? No, I've you're getting to hear some new stuff. So I'm great with that.
Dude, that is,
I'm here to just spread music, drink whiskey, and that was one. I started getting into video production. I found that to be just as filling and kind of fun. And that was the first video that I really, there's a ton of layers there and there's a lot of rendering and, you know, because that's what I felt like I needed to have to communicate just all the things that swirl around in your head and just, you know, dinosaurs and just all kinds of weird stuff, you know, that we think about every day.
Yeah, that's literally my new favorite song.
Oh, well, thank you very much. I'm glad you enjoyed that, Steve.
I've heard Chris' first song, In the Garden.
Ah, yes. You know what, Dom? Someday, it's a song, and it's near and dear to me. I kind of wrote it during the pandemic, and it just... My wife and I have a very beautiful backyard. It's not that big, but we have a deck and we have a flower garden and we have a vegetable garden. And sitting out there and being with one another and walking around the neighborhood is what kept us from losing our friggin' minds during the pandemic. And I have a song called The Beautiful Garden, and it just kind of encapsulated some of that. Dom's heard it. Basically, no one else ever has. And someday everyone else will. When you have something that's really near and dear to you, yeah, it's kind of funny because you almost, and I know Dom has a couple songs like this, that you're almost weird about sharing it because it's maybe a little too personal or a little too, it feels really risky to share it. But I will at some point. There's no question in my mind. I've just got to kind of get back to it and do the vocals the way because again, it was an early song. I was totally happy with the instrumentation, but I was still rediscovering my voice on some levels, and I was never totally happy with the vocals on it. So I'm going to tweak the lyrics a little bit and recut the vocals as I sing now, and I think then I'll put it out.
Well, I guarantee you, just with the story behind it, that I know Nina Nino will love it as well because she's in the gardens too. And yeah, we have same thing. For a minute, I thought you were stalking me because I'm like, why are you talking about my backyard?
But it's our little piece of paradise, you know? When we came into a little bit of money when her folks passed, and you know, we put a new roof on the house and just tried to improve the place. And we had a terrible backyard, just this pathetic falling apart deck. And she said, tear it down. There's a contractor in the church who builds decks. Let's hire him and let's build what we really want. And so I drew up the plans and said, Ron, here's what we want. And he built it for us. And, you know, we've had that deck for close to 20 years now, and it's Trex or that kind of engineered wood, and it's amazing. We're so glad. It was some of the best money we ever spent because it made that outdoor space wonderful.
Yeah, that's awesome. So are there any more live songs you want to play?
Sure.
I know we're at the hour and a half, and I definitely want to end here in time for Dom's because I'm going to be there for sure because I love Dom. I consider him my brother. He's a great guy.
He's my boy. Well, let's see. Do we want to do something serious? Do we want to do something silly? What do you want to hear?
Well, I have when we do end, I always keep the chat going, and I have two songs that I'm going to play at the end to keep the chat going, and I don't know what, if you remember which ones I had, but maybe something silly or upbeat.
All right. Well, this is kind of a reference to pandemic was on everybody's mind because that just consumed us. So this is my skewed view of living in the pandemic.
woke up this morning and I looked around, trying to figure out what's going down. I guess I got them, I got the New Year's blues. If this year's like the last year, I don't know what I'm gonna do. I ain't got no job, can't afford no gas. Inflation and food prices are kicking my ass. And just 5 days till my rent is due. If this year's like the last year, I don't know what I'm gonna do. Yeah, back in 2019 I was sailing along. The world's my oyster and I'm feeling strong. And then before you knew it, here comes that Wuhan flu. Is it any wonder I got them New Year's blues? Yeah, the way things are going from a bad to worse. My next Uber ride's gonna be in a hearse. That hot girl from Tinder turned out to be a prude. None for me. Is it any wonder I got them New Year's blues?
Here's a little guitar part.
Everybody's pissed off and the world is a mess. And I don't even think we've seen the worst of it yet. Ah, the shit's getting crazy from here to Timbuktu. Yeah, the whole fucking world has got them New Year's blues. Now, if you're offended or if you felt dissed, please know I'm joking and I hope you ain't pissed. I laugh at my life, it's all that I can do. If we laugh together, won't have them New Year's blues. New Year's, New Year's blues. New Year's, New Year's blues. Won't have them New Year's blues. Let's all laugh together.
That was awesome, man. I'm over here dancing to it. And it's an upbeat song, but it's so true at the same time. Like, all those lyrics were just right on.
Oh, thank you very much, Steve. I appreciate it. And thank you, everyone in the chat. Very grateful for everybody hanging out and listening to a little bit of what I do.
That's good stuff. And in a half hour, you can listen to Chris and Dom more on Dom's channel. I pinned the link at the top. Thank you, JM. And because that's where I'm heading for sure when we're down here. Because you and Dom are great people, and I love you guys. It's awesome.
Well, thanks so much. We like hanging out. I will. I'll play you this one, and this is one that I kind of, like I told you, sometimes I want to send a message, but I want to do it in a fun way that's presumably not too offensive, although you might be the judge of offensive on this one. But not a big fan, because I am a publisher, I've done this, I am a staunch advocate of freedom of speech, even if it's stupid, even if it's wrong, even if it's we need to hear all opinions. And big tech, especially during the pandemic, but in plenty of other instances, they really shut down the exchange of ideas. And the founding fathers of the United States were not about that. They believed in freedom of press. Again, even if it's wrong, the best thing, you guys, if you're old enough, remember the Skokie Nazis, all these, you know, wannabe Nazis in Illinois. And we let them speak. We let them march around, and everybody looked at them and said, those guys are morons. And that's what should happen with ideas. Let them be on their merit, and you can look at it and go, no, that's not for me. But this song is called Zuckerberg Can Suck My Balls.
Well, I just got out of Facebook jail. I
I'm hungry, tired, my face is pale. His censors act like I'm the jerk for asking if these vaccines work. So Zuckerberg can suck my balls. See, I like it when his stock price falls. Billionaire, billionaire, take his cash and make him care. Zuckerberg can suck my balls. Yeah, I'm living on his book of face. It makes me miss the old MySpace. You can speak your mind all night long and learn to go.
I screwed up my own lyrics. But let's remember that Zuckerberg can suck my balls.
I like it when his stock price falls. Millionaire, billionaire, take his cash and make him care. Zuckerberg can suck my balls.
Old Mark, he's stolen your right to speech by throttling the number of folks that you can reach. So if you're asking, hey, what can I do about it? Let's start by kicking Mark in his wallet. So come on, brother, speak with boldness. If millions of us do it, I think he'll notice. And Zuckerberg can suck my balls. I like it when his stock price falls. See, the internet's a battleground. Don't let censors shut you down. Zuckerberg can suck my balls.
Ah, suck it, Mark, you techno-fascist. Suck 'em. Suck my big old balls.
Oh, dude, that was awesome, man. I love it. What? That was great.
You know, I'm an old hippie, and back in the 70s, you had protest songs, and that's just what that is, just a protest song, raising consciousness. Was, I really don't I want do, Mark I'm, anywhere near my balls, but my point is, you know, look at how companies are doing that, and if you don't agree with where they're at, take your dollars elsewhere, folks, or your rubles, or whatever your currency.
I'm really, really big into the 1A and 2A community. And I do. I believe that even if I don't agree with what somebody has to say, you have the right as an American citizen to say it. You know, so just because I disagree doesn't mean you have to shut the hell up, you know. But everything that song said, I agree with 100%.
Shutting down the discussion is the wrong way to go about anything. Have a reasonable discussion amongst adults and decide your position. You might find your position evolves or changes over time. But if you are not allowed to express yourself or have others express themselves to you, nothing ever changes, and we just become tribal, and that ain't the right way to go, folks, in my view.
Yeah, me neither. Exactly. Yeah, JM, I agree with JM. That's now my new favorite song. That was great, man. I loved it. That was awesome.
Well, I know Clay Conspiracy. I slipped that to him one time. It was late night, and it was on my SoundCloud at that time. I've never done a video for that one for obvious reasons. And honestly, the reason I haven't done it is because I want to go old school. Remember where you had the bouncing ball going along the lyrics? As soon as I figure out how to do that, I'm going to do a video for that song. But you got to have the bouncing ball, and I'll, you know, go from a football to a basketball to anyway.
Yeah, Zuckerberg can suck my balls. That's great.
Again, you get deep inside your mind stuff here, and then you get stupid shit like that. So that is my, what you see is what you get, folks. I'm those two contradictions wrapped up in one, a deep, serious thinker and a total idiot, all at the same time.
Well, we got a lot in common then. We have a lot in common when it comes to that. Because I overanalyze everything and I'm really deep. But then at the same time, it's, you know, I'm like my buddy Ed Hen and Joe Kerr just constantly cracking joke, you know.
Well, you got to laugh your way through life because life is otherwise.
It's good natural medicine, that's for sure.
Yep, indeed. All right. So we got, what, 40 minutes of, what do you want to do now? Do you want to play videos? Do you want to answer some questions? What do you want to do? I'm here for whatever you want, brother.
Well, I'm thinking we got, because I got two that I'm going to play at the end to leave the chat rolling. And then there's about 20 minutes left before you and Dom go on.
Yep.
So, I don't know if you got another one you want to play real quick. And then,
I got a bunch. I will play, again, this is a message song in that, you know, there's something, my family and my wife's family going literally back to the Revolutionary War have served in the armed services. And I don't think that this country takes the kind of care of its veterans that it should. Some of them gave a lot, some of them gave all, and they should be treated with respect. They should be given the health care and the benefits and things that they were promised, and that doesn't always happen. Yep. So this is a song that talks about that a little bit. It's called Christmas Whiskey.
Christmas whiskey, I feel your bite. Take me through this winter's night. You should be here, but I drink alone, trying to forget you're never coming home. We joined up when we were young to save the world and fight unsung. And so we served, and we served with pride. But over there, a part of us just died. The season's colors, they all turned gray. Color left my world the night you went away. We lost our friends to midnight attacks. We both came home, but you never came back. The songs tell us that a king was born. I once believed, but now I'm torn. The things we saw, they make this season hard. Those deaths on Christmas Eve that left a scar. Cold and alone, you walk the streets, fighting the demons you couldn't beat. Pull you back, oh Lord knows I tried, but you decided on suicide. Whiskey that we said we'd share. I look across and you're not there. You should be here, my friend, but I drink alone, trying to forget that you never came home. No, you never came home.
Oh, I forgot to unmute myself. Yeah, that is, wow. Yeah, that is a deep song. That's and it's so true. Like what you said is, they need to treat our vets way, way better.
Yeah, unfortunately, the rate of suicide amongst veterans is so very high. And you know, when you, the experiences you have over there, and my nephew, did five tours. Hunted Saddam Hussein as a tank commander too, and then did three tours in Afghanistan as a ground pounder, and literally lost some of his friends, and he did not come back the same. And you know, and he had been on a better trajectory, and then had a motorcycle accident and had another traumatic brain injury, which he had suffered while in combat, and it is not going well for him. So, you know, we say, you know, respect your veterans and everything, but you know, if you can help veterans groups, or if you know someone that needs some help, reach out to them. Especially if you're a serviceman yourself, you understand better what they deal with than a civilian would.
Yeah, because that's the sad part, is that the government makes all these promises, and then afterwards they're like, yeah, we got what we wanted. Like, screw you.
Yeah, the government basically is not great about keeping promises. Ask our Native American friends.
Yeah. Yep. As Native Hawaiians, they'll tell you.
Yeah, indeed. But there we are. All right. Let's see. What else can we do? I am going to actually do a cover because I really like this cover. And again, it kind of encapsulates some of the things that we... What the heck? All right. Yeah, this... Pete Townsend wrote this song in, I think, 72, and it's about as true today as it was back in 72, so... Fighting in the streets with our children at our feet, and the morals that they worship will be gone, and the men who spurred us on sit in judgment of our wrong. They decide, and the shotgun sings the song. Tip my hat to the new constitution, take a bow for the new revolution, smile and grin at the change all around me, pick up my guitar and play, just like yesterday, now I get on my knees and pray. Well, don't get fooled again. Yeah, the change, it had to come. We knew it all along. We were liberated from the fold, but that's all. And the world's just the same, and the history ain't changed, 'cause the banners, they all flow in the last war. Tip my hat to the new constitution, take a bow for the new revolution, smile and grin at the change all around me, pick up my guitar and play, just like yesterday, now I get on my knees and pray. We don't get fooled again. I move myself and my family aside. If we happen to be left half alive, I get on my papers and smile at the sky. Know that the hypnotized never lie. Nothing in the streets looks any different to me, and the slogans all replaced by and by.
parting on the left is now the parting on the right. And the beards, they all grew longer overnight. Yeah, I tip my hat to the new constitution. Take up a bow for the new revolution. Smiling, grin at the change all around me. Picking my guitar and playing just like yesterday. Now I get on my knees and pray. Don't get fooled again. Don't get fooled again. Oh, no, no, no.
The Who, everybody.
Yeah. Yeah, there's no lie right there. It has not changed a bit from 72 to now. Unfortunately, people boss. Are still getting fooled.
Yep, meet the new boss, same as the old boss.
Yep. That's my my new favorite saying, and I actually want to make this into a t-shirt or a hat, or whatever you want, a decal for the back of your window, but doesn't matter if you're left or right, red or blue, the government don't give a shit about you.
And that is unfortunate. The government cares about the government, and people in power care about staying in power. And it's been true when there was kings and lords, and it's true with democracies, and it's true with bureaucrats. It's just how it is.
And absolutely.
People need to recognize that. All right. Well, Steve, I got to tell you, had the time of my life.
Dude, me too. And
thank you very
I
much
still
for
got
inviting
the,
me on the show.
The Zuckerberg song is still in my head. I'm going to wake up tomorrow morning and still be singing it. Like, I can't get that song out of my head.
I got to tell you, as a songwriter, that makes your heart go pitter-pat. If you have something that you can earworm somebody and is memorable, a hook that's memorable, yeah. As a songwriter, you feel like I've won, you know. And
well, you so won.
Thank you very
for
much
me,
for sure.
As far as I'm concerned, you won for sure. And I'm sure a lot of people in chat feel the same way. Because man, that's just you definitely won.
Well, thank you very much. You are too kind, and thank you again for the invitation to be on your show and to speak to your audience. It was my great pleasure to be here. Hey, there's Nina. Nina.
Hey, Chris.
Hi, Nina. How are you, dear?
Good. Awesome show.
Oh, thank you. Hey, you know, your husband is a wonderful host, and I was very, I felt very blessed to be here.
I feel blessed that you came on, and I'm very grateful for it and appreciate you coming on, too. It's awesome. You're good people, and I think good people find good people. Because that's just how God wants it, you know. And then we keep spreading the love and the goodness, and it's contagious.
Peace and love, aggressively in your face.
Aggressively in your face.
I'm going to love you, and you'll like it.
So, hopefully. But before we go, though, if there are any newcomers or anyone out there that's thinking about going into music or would there be any advice you would want to give to them?
Yeah. And, you know, we talked about this before the show. Let's see if my answer kind of matches other people. When I started out, I sucked. And everybody was happy to tell me that I sucked. And I continued to suck until I got better. And even when I knew I was getting better, people continued to tell you you suck. And at some point, you need to be okay with who you are and how, and if this is the best you can do this day, be okay with that and continue to, it doesn't matter where you start and it doesn't matter where you are right now, just keep going and endeavor to improve, endeavor to get better. And of course, that takes practice. And to a certain extent, and it's not ego, but just that sense of self that this is who I am. am, and this is what I'm going to do. And if I like it, if no one else likes it, it doesn't matter because I like it. Now, if I like it and other people like it, that is the best. And that is just so wonderful and uplifting. But start there, folks. Doesn't matter where you are, try and get better and work your craft and feel good about what you're doing, because that, at the end of the day, is what matters.
Absolutely. Yeah, be yourself and do, yeah, I love that. That's awesome. Be yourself and do you.
Do you.
And it's so true. That's so true on so many levels. Like any, like, yeah, I love that, Chris. Awesome. Thank you for saying that. That's a great advice. Really great advice. I mean, same thing with plumbing. I don't mean to switch it from music to plumbing, but when I first started, I sucked. I mean, everybody sucks at anything when they first start, right? You're not just, you just don't wake up one day and you're, you know, Michael Jordan.
Nope, 10,000 hours.
Michael Jordan didn't even wake up one day and was Michael Jordan. He was kicked off the high school basketball team. So, I mean, you know. But
exactly.
Yeah.
So Einstein had a little trouble in school. It doesn't matter where you're at. It's where you're going. And, you know, just have that sense of yourself to go, I'm going to continue to work at this and I'm going to get better. If I put in the work, I'm always going to get better.
Absolutely, man. Absolutely. So, all right. Awesome. So I'm going to leave the chat going for a little bit. I'm going to play two more songs by Chris Lane Sr. And
everyone go to Dom
Turgo, the Dominator. It is linked at the top. And then once this is done, we're all going to be over there. So I hope to see you guys there. And thank you all 46 people for hitting the like button. And for all everyone to hit the like button over on Chris Lane Sr. channel as well. I can't see that part. So, but with that being said, thank you, Chris Lane Sr. Much love and aloha to you, brother.
And aloha, guys. Else. Be well.
Love you, Chris.
Have a beautiful morning.
Thanks, guys.
A beautiful day, a beautiful afternoon, a beautiful evening, a beautiful night, whatever it may be, wherever you are. Much love, much aloha, and most importantly, God bless.
Refusing to see, living it by wishing and hoping. I got a taste, no way to be free. You better live with your eyes wide open. Stop believing the lies that you're fed. Get wise to the way things are going. Get the truth and hand me your head. When the truth is a lie. And lies are all you can see. You can't criticize. And they don't listen to you or me. Prepare for the times. Our masters are the fathers of lies. Convicting for crimes. I jail you while your liberty dies. Gonna live with my eyes wide open. All around me refusing to see. Laying there by wishing and hoping. I got a taste, no way to be free. You better live with your eyes wide open. Stop believing the lies that you're fed. Been wise to the way things are going. Get the truth. Hand me your head. It's a pen of mine to disguise what's going on. They claim it's the truth, but it's nothing but a giant con. Do you really think elites give a fuck about you? The reality stinks. Conspiracies keep proving they're true. What's it gonna take to pry your eyes open?
You have to know that things ain't real. Repeat the same lies over and over, adding to the freedoms they steal.
Can't see beyond this darker selling pretty little lies. Antiquity burning on the midnight skies. The dark age is here, and it's ready to fly. Darkness and dense gloom.